collectors versus hoarders. Let's see. Well, when I first started into this hobby, I didn't know a lot about what I liked, right? I didn't know my preferences. I didn't know, you know, what kind of pen I wanted, the size that I liked, the type of nib that I liked. But I was fascinated by the number of colors, the way that people explained to me, like, how personable a fountain pen can be and how tailor-fit a fountain pen could be for a person's hands. So I guess when I started off into this, I could even be nothing but a hoarder, because all I was doing is I was searching and I was exploring and just trying all the different things that I could try, just to be able to, you know, understand that thing that they were talking about. A person once came up to me and talked to me about this nib called a stub, and it was a nib that a pen that when you would write with it without doing anything differently would add so much more expressiveness to your writing. And I was like, what's the idea of that? What do you mean it shows up more expressively and whatnot? I don't have to change anything about what I'm doing. And explained, yeah. So I became obsessed with, you know, being able to hunt down similar nibs, so that's how the kind of the accumulation started. So at the beginning of it very much is a little bit of a, you know, of a, people kind of go into this with a bit of a hoarding tendency, only because they're searching, they're wandering, there's no place to aim for, so all you can do is explore into the abyss.